enterprises will mean opportunities for the next generation.
So they're planning to produce oxygen by mining on the moon. Well, to kids of today, especially those kids who might be planning on being engineers, that's something that they can be thinking about, because right now nobody really knows how to mine on the moon and get oxygen.
Already countless thousands of workers earn their living from space.
Barbara and I were trying to figure out if everybody who's involved in the project were around here, there'd be, you know, tens of thousands of people. You know, for one launch, it'd be a whole
country. It's really exciting.
Ultimately, what lies ahead in the future is a mystery. Technology may be noble, but the human mind and heart are full of secrets. One of the great unknowns is whether space exploration will bring us peace or war. Star Wars, the strategic defense initiative, is on the drawing boards of the 1980s. Who knows what will be on the drawing boards 50 years from now?
There's a myth that there's some sinister, evil, new project underway that there's this program to militarize space. But in fact, we have used space for good and legitimate purposes since the inception.
It's really the people themselves, through their Congress and through the administration, that make the decisions as to how much of our technology should be used for military purposes.
Krista McAuliffe believes looking at the Earth as a whole may help nations see beyond their differences.
Looking at the world as a unit, the people, I'm sure, who went to the moon because they were able to see the whole world as this globe, came back with a much better perspective of why we all should work together. Because we are pretty fragile when you look at the whole universe. So maybe as more and more people get out and get that perspective, things are going to change.
Ever since movies were invented, film directors have enjoyed fantasizing about unearthly adventures, but now the line between science fiction and science fact is becoming blurred.
Background action! Action!
Space Camp is a feature film in production right now. The plot takes some kids on a tour of the space shuttle where it unexpectedly blasts off.
There, and then do it just like the big time. Here we go.
Space Camp is fiction. There's no way the shuttle could lift off by accident. But the shuttle is a reality, and living without gravity is a reality, and even Space Camp is a reality.
Roger, main, we have main ignition.
3, 2, we are go for SRB ignition.
It's a place in Huntsville, Alabama, where girls and boys can spend a few days getting as close to the experience of space travel as you can get without accidentally taking off.
I've learned a lot more this whole week than I've learned reading about space and the shuttle and all of these missions.
I really want to learn about space, and I want to know what the future is for us in space.
Let's go. Let's go. We don't want to be okay, kids.
I would like to be an astronaut and go on a rocket to go up to Mars.
Untangle that carefully.
The young astronauts from the St. Barnabas School in Philadelphia have found a less elaborate way to explore space. With Sister Marie Diane, they will launch a rocket they designed. This exercise will ignite their imagination and heighten their technical skills.
The thing that I like about space is not so much outer space, but the implications for inner space. I like all the things that they have learned in space that help us on Earth. I think that going out to space, solving a lot of those difficulties, help us on Earth solving our own problems like pollution and so on. Once the excitement is sparked, I think it just explodes to the whole world. It's fantastic.
We're the lifeline of your business day. We let them know that you're okay. We're working hard in every way. calls go through. And every time you make a call, we're the ones who do it all. More than sending you boys, we bring the world to you.
We're the one for you, New England. New England Telephone.
Part of the NYNEX family, and an important part of your business, too.
If we could light a candle for everything he's done, for every life he's bettered, for every victory won, that light would shine so brightly that all the world would see all he did for peace and freedom and equality.
McDonald's joins the nation in celebrating the legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King, Jr.
Takes to make it easy. We've got what it takes to make it good.
During January, get a Magnolia printed oak finished toilet seat for only $9.88. Look for the Hardware Value of the Month banner at participating True Value hardware stores.
We've got what it takes, True Value.
Just 1 hour. That's all it would take to help fill this room. That's all it takes to help save lives. That's usually how long it takes to give blood. Giving blood is a safe procedure that's easy to do and as painless as a pinch. Join WBZ's 14th annual Blood Brotherhood on Friday, January 31st at the John Hancock Observatory and Saturday, February 1st at the Computer Museum. Or call the American Red Cross at 1-800-442-2053. Don't miss London's famous Sadler's Wells Royal Ballet. Performing Tchaikovsky's romantic classic, The Sleeping Beauty, a magical production, grand and spectacular. At the Wang Center for the Performing Arts, Boston, January 30th through February 2nd. For more information, call 1-800-223-0120.
Representing the teaching profession, and most of all, representing you from Concord, New Hampshire.
It is New Year's in Concord, New Hampshire, a town that is over 200 years old. Concord is reveling in the glory of one of its own who has become a heroine. It is almost as if the town of Concord, too, will orbit the earth.
It's very important, especially to a town like Concord that's kind of a sleepy town, even though it's the state capital. Well, she's the first teacher in space. The first teacher, and also a woman, thank goodness.
I want to be an astronaut because of Kristen McAuliffe. It's going to be a big experience for our class.
The thrill is everywhere. The third grade at the Kimball Elementary School, a chapter of young astronauts, is part of the enthusiasm. Scott McAuliffe and his classmates are gearing up to watch Krista head for space in the Challenger.
The space program captures the passion that young kids have about their world. The idea of blasting off from this Earth and exploring the universe is something that captures the imagination of kids like dinosaurs do, and monsters, and they weave the fantasy into the rocketry.
Zachary Freed is Scott McAuliffe's best friend and classmate. His lifelong fascination has been given an exclamation point because of Krista's adventure.
I'm interested in space and a little of the human body. I first started when I was 4 years old, and I first drew pictures of planets. I would like to be a millionaire when I grow up. I might earn money when I go up in space.
Krista McAuliffe's triumph has given the town of Concord, and particularly the teaching profession, a sense of pride. Krista's spirit is contagious. The teachers of Concord have acquired a new self-image.
I think it will inspire parents. I think it will inspire administrators to look and say, gee,
you know, we've got some good people out there, and they're proving it now. They've chosen her, and she has shown what a lot of teachers have, and there's a lot of good teachers out there who, with support, can really get through to kids and really get them fired up.
The months and weeks of training and waiting have now shrunk to days and hours. The Challenger stands poised on launch pad 39B as mission 51L nears liftoff.
We're happy to have Krista on board. I think she's an asset to the crew, and the flight is going to be fun for us, and we want it to be fun for her. We want her to be interested, enjoy it.
There are two things that the commander told me to do, and he said, the first one, he said, I want you to have fun, and the second one, he said, look out the window.
In a sense, the most important part of Krista's mission will begin only after she lands, because then she will crisscross the country for several months and speak to the whole nation about space.
Basically, what we're going to be doing is sharing our experiences, explaining some of the things that took place on the shuttle that the teachers were involved in, and we're going to have kind of a lecture circuit type of thing that will start probably in March or so and continue until school will start next year.
When Krista becomes ambassador from NASA, no doubt she will let America in on a secret astronauts have known for years, that space is about to become part of everyday life.
Not that we're going to go leaping into colonization right away, but I think within 20 years we're going to see ordinary people just going up as passengers for the weekend. When the space station gets up there and we have hotels up there, then folks will take off on Friday and go up, spend the weekend, and come back to work on Tuesday.
Can you think of somebody being born in space and on a space station living there, or traveling to another planet, or having a colony set up on Mars?
In autumn, Krista's contract with NASA will end. What will she do then? What will life outside the spotlight be like?
That's been my life, and I really enjoy teaching, and I feel I do a good job, and that's a good commitment for me. So I do plan on being back in the classroom, and I feel that the Teacher in Space program would lose an awful lot if the teacher never returned to the classroom.
Krista McAuliffe will return to Concord High School because she knows the true mission lies with her students, and when she comes back from her adventures, she will have more than ever to give them.
There's things that I see a lot of times in a classroom that just makes me want to cry, because kids will set such low limits for themselves. You know, kids have to push themselves a little bit more. I think it makes them feel good. And they don't have to set themselves very realistic bounds sometimes. You know, it's not a thing that I would say to kids, you know, don't dream. You know, well, you're only a C student in English, so you're never going to be a poet. You know, dreaming's okay.
Thank you.
transcript, send $2 and a self-addressed stamped envelope to Teacher in Space, Special Projects, WBZ-TV, 1170 Soldiers Field Road, Boston, Mass., 02134.